Hello everyone, it's Eddie the Magic Monk. In the following lessons, I'm gonna take you guys through some SQL, which is the language that is used to interact with databases. And we're gonna learn this in the environment Microsoft Access. So if you don't have Microsoft Access, it's probably easier if you get it if you want to follow through this tutorial. It's just part of the Microsoft Office suite. So if you open up Microsoft Access, the first window, my version is Access 2016, the first window, you will just create a blank desktop database. So just click that and choose where you want to save it. So I'm going to save it called, let's say, tutorial.accdb, and where you want to save it, you can change the folder path if you want to save it somewhere else. Click create, and you can see that it's opened up your database with one single table. So I'm going to delete this table because I want to let's close the table. And let's go to tables. Oh, there is no table anyway. It wasn't created yet. So yeah, this is a totally blank database. It's got nothing in it. So we're going to start off by getting you guys to create a table in SQL. So you're going to click create, query design, and then this thing shows up. Don't worry about it, just click close, and then you're going to click on SQL view. Okay, you can access it by clicking SQL view or click SQL view on the bottom right. It means the same thing, so click SQL view. And the first query we're going to do is to create a table. So SQL is pretty simple. If you want to create a table, you can just type create table and type the name of your table. So let's say I'm gonna make a simple database for a small school. So I'm gonna have students. All right, so each student is basically gonna have a student ID. So let's put S_ID and let's make it an integer. And let's make it not null, which means it's not going to be allowed to have any empty empty rows. So we can't add a row where a student does not have a student ID. And we're also going to make it the primary key. And the reason for that is because every student is going to have a different ID, so we can use it to identify every single student. So student ID is the primary key, and for each student we're gonna store their last name, and it's going to be a variable character, which means a character a field with however many characters they want, up to, let's say, a name will only be up to, let's say, 50 characters. Can't imagine a name with more than that. Actually, let's just put 100 to be safe. So each student needs a last name, a first name, actually 100 is probably too many, let's just give it 50. And then address. Oh, in that case, let's give it more characters. You can only have up to 255 characters. And let's say each person then has a phone number, and let's give it an integer again, because phone numbers are basically numbers. And if you want a number with a decimal, then the code for that is basically, let's say we got print balance, so how much money they have in their printer account. Now let's make it float, meaning that it's a decimal number, but you're gonna have to change the settings later for how many decimals you want them to have. And let's say that is it. So close the bracket, finish it off. And if we run it right now, it should create a table. So run. And you can see here that a table has showed up in students. And if you open up students, you can see that we have just created a table and it's got all these fields in it. Now, you can also go into the design view of the table and you can see that these are basically the field names and the data types that you've assigned. Okay, so the SQL did work. And the text fields have a field size of 50, so they did work. Okay, so that is the first tutorial, how to create a table. We will learn how to insert some data in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching. See you next time.